Hello. When performing an attenuation or link loss test on a fiber optic system, one must make sure that they have the appropriate setup. Over the next few minutes, I will go over the steps required to manually configure the OTS600 test set for testing a multimode system 62.5 with patch panels on either end. Please ensure that your test sets have been on for at least 5 minutes to make sure that they're warmed up. So over here, I do have a couple of items. I have my jumpers, and I have some cleaning supplies, and of course, I got my safety glasses. So starting with your source, make sure that it's configured for the right wavelength, and it's ready to send a reference power over to the test meter, which is also configured for the same wavelengths. In this case, we'll be switching between 850 nanometer and 1300 nanometer wavelengths. I will pick up my first jumper, which is an ST-SC jumper, because I have an ST port on this side. I will clean my jumper and plug it into my test set. And then I will apply a mandrel wrap. Clean the other end and plug it into my meter. And then I will send a reference power to the unit. And I can see from my unit that I'm receiving the specified reference power. If that was not the case, I would replace the jumper or clean and try again. After that, I will set a reference point at this power level, and of course, the unit will zero out. The next thing I will do is, using an adapter, I want to test this connectors on the second jumper to ensure that they're clean and that they're quality connectors. So I will clean both ends before I plug into my meter. And I am looking for a value of 0.3 dB and below, because the specifications say that this connector pair should perform to said specifications, 0.3 dB. And looking at my meter, I see that the values are indeed less than 0.3 dB and that I have a good test setup. Now, if this jumper, the second jumper, gave you losses greater than a 0.3 over dB, then you would replace the jumper and keep trying until you get a good jumper that gives you the right reading so that you know that your system is ready for testing. And that is it. All right, so we are ready to test. Just disconnect these two guys and plug into either end of your patch panels. One thing to remember is do not remove the jumper on the source side. If you remove the jumper on the source side, you will lose your reference and have to start over again. That's pretty important. And when testing single mode systems, replace the jumpers with the appropriate single mode jumpers. You do not need a mandrel wrap when testing single mode systems. Make sure that your OTS test sets are configured for the right wavelengths, 1310, 1550, and what have you. And that's it. If you got any questions, give us a call or send us an email at landscapesolutions@corning.com. And we do recommend that you obtain fiber optic training. Thank you.